So we have this crazy world, and it gets crazier. The idea is to keep us so focused on survival. It's like that mass mind control manual that came to light a few years ago called Silent Weapons for a Quiet War, How to Manipulate the Population. And one of the lines in it said, keep them busy, busy, busy back on the farm with the other animals. So the more you can keep us in a state of survival, more and more stress. Look, mate, you might be saying interesting things, but I live in the real world, mate. That's the idea, to keep us in that state of stress. And we're now bringing it to younger and younger people. Kids under tremendous stress to pass exams, to show how indoctrinated they are in the system. Oh, you must pass your exams. Oh, my son got a... I've seen it on car stickers. My son got so-and-so. I'm very pleased for you. By the way, he got it, you didn't. This parental glory-seeking. Oh, God, you've got to pass your exams. You're going to be a banker. Your mum wants you to be a banker. Pressure, pressure, pressure. Whatever happened to life? How do you spell happy, teacher? What's all that about? Do we ever talk about that? Are you happy? Are you fulfilled? You know, people, we have these measurements of success that are sold to us that we take on, and they're all about more. More and more and more. How many more people are this? How many more people are that? How many more people are this? How many more people have passed degrees? How many more people have got a mortgage? How many more people? And yet, it's the other way. It tells the real story. How few people are unfulfilled. How few people are under stress. How few people are ill. How few people are homeless. How few people are terrified of the future. These are the measurements of a success of society, surely. Not more and more and more. You know, we have an economic system, which I call take, make, and throw away, where the whole thing of success is called economic growth, is how fast you can take from the earth, turn it into things, sell more things, throw away more things, and start again. The faster you do that, the more successful you are. And we call it the cutting edge of human society. It's turning the planet into a shite hole. And we have the cleverness up to a point, although if we went to wisdom, we would find that technologically we would advance by enormous strides. But we have the cleverness through mind at the moment to create some amazing technology. Things that could make the world a better place for everybody. But we use that technology to pepper bomb cities full of civilians. We are now such at the cutting edge of human evolution that we can kill more people than ever before. And we do. We're in a world where it seems okay for children to sign their names on bombs that then drop and kill other children. Like I say, we think the world is sane. Well, we people in this room don't, but so many people do, when it is utterly insane. And what keeps people from understanding this? The constant hypnotic trance that we put in. You are feeling sleepy. Tick-tock, tick-tock. You don't want to know about pepper-bombing cities. Watch this. Shut up. Quick, honey. She's going for the car. Whoa. We live in a world of plenty, and yet people starve for the want of the basics. We have food galore in some parts of the world, which comes often from the parts of the world that go hungry. And we throw away more food than most people eat in many, many months. I've seen this in Ecuador. People living on rubbish tips, waiting for the vans to come from the Western hotels to pour the rubbish food, throwing away food on, and then they go and eat for the day from it. the world that we've allowed to happen. But don't look at that. TikTok, TikTok. Look at this. Shut up. Hey, quick, honey. The Steelers are going to score. Cool, yeah, yeah. I've got nothing against that. I love sport. But if we are in a situation where that becomes the focus of our reality at the exclusion of everything else, then while we're looking here, hell is going on here to stitch us up in the way that we have been. Oh, shut up. What's on the telly, honey? I mean, we drop bombs on the most crowded piece of land on the earth, Gaza. We protect ourselves. That's what we do. We do it to protect ourselves, apparently. This is what we do. This is liberation. Yay, liberation. And it's been going on. This is Vietnam. In the 20th century, humans killed well in excess of 100 million other humans in wars and conflicts. And it's still going on. TikTok, TikTok, well, you don't want to see that. Hey, quick, honey, Paris Hilton's half naked in the back of a limousine. Come and look, it's really good. And that's the new religion. Instead of living life, hey, this is me, I'm going to live my life. Ooh, isn't that she got a nice dress on that there's this show, isn't she, and stuff. Oh, look, she's going to marry so-and-so. Oh, they've been divorced, yeah. It's the new religion, the celebrity, the religion of celebrity. I'm just in the supermarket. Oh, yeah, I'm getting some beans. They're up there. They don't have to shop in a supermarket because they're different. And then we have a situation where we have a system called money, which is based on money that has never, does not, and will never exist. Steps back in amazement. Say it again. I didn't quite catch that. We have become so divorced from the world that we live in that most people never ask the simple question, what is money? When you go into a bank and you ask for a loan, $50,000 or something, what does the bank do? It does nothing in terms of moving precious metal anywhere, printing money, anything. It just types into your account $50,000. And from that moment on, you start paying back interest and eventually the principal, if you're lucky, on the $50,000. Because the same people that have controlled the politicians and the governments have controlled the banks, legislation has been passed which allows banks to lend at least 10 times, and my God, it's at least 10 times, what they have on deposit. So every time you put a dollar in a bank, you're giving them the right legally to lend 10, 9, 10 dollars. And interestingly, when you, say, take out a loan for $50,000, that $50,000 has been given to your computer screen on the basis of someone else putting a fraction of that in the bank. And then you take that $50,000 and maybe you give someone $20,000 to buy something. They'll take that $20,000, which has already been created out of nothing, and they'll put it in another bank. Now the $20,000 from the original $50,000 gives this bank the right to lend 10 times the $20,000. And so it goes on. What a bank can create out of nothing and charge interest on to the population from $1 or $100 or whatever the figure is fantastic. And we don't ask questions. I've talked to economists, you know, who are earning cuckoo land amounts of money on the telly and stuff. I say, what is money? How is it created? They can't tell you. They never thought about it. It's just there. It's governments. No. It's the DNA of this society which holds this society more than anything else in so many ways, on a physical level, in servitude. Money created out of nothing, called debt, credit, which we then spend the rest of our lives paying back. But don't look at that. Don't let them know that. Tick, tick, tick. Hey, quick, honey, it's the Jerry Springer Show. This man's going to punch his girlfriend. Come and look, honey. These are all the diversions constantly. And then, of course, these people will tell you all the news that those that own the media want you to believe is true. It's what news is. And the whole foundation of all of it is be afraid, be very afraid, the big bad monster is coming as soon as we've invented him. Keep people in fear. Keep people in states of stress. And crucially, this will have implications as we go through the day, keep them in a state of surviving. Because while they're doing that, they will be in a state of focus on survival rather than looking at the big picture of what's going on.
What's wrong with the world, mama? People living like they ain't got no mamas. I think the whole world's addicted to the drama, only attracted to things that'll bring the trauma. Overseas, yeah, we trying to stop terrorism, but we still got terrorists here living in the USA, the big CIA, the Bloods and the Crips and the KKK. But if you only have love for your own race, then you only leave space to discriminate, and to discriminate only generates hate. And when you hate, then you're bound to get irate. Yeah, madness is what you demonstrate, and that's exactly how anger works and operates. Man, you gotta have love just to set it straight. Take control of your mind and meditate. Let your soul gravitate to the love, y'all.
People killing, people dying, children hurting, hidden, crying. Can you practice what you preach and what you turn the other cheek? Father, 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 help us. Send some guidance from above. These people got me questioning. Where is the love?
Where is the love? Where is the love?
Where is the love? The love?
It just ain't the same. Always in change. New days are strange. Is the world insane? If love and peace is so strong, why are the pieces of love that don't belong? Nations dropping bombs, chemical gases filling lungs of little ones with ongoing suffering as the youth are young. So ask yourself, is the loving really gone? So I could ask myself, really what is going wrong in this world that we living in? People keep on giving in, making wrong decisions, only visions of the dividends. Not respecting each other, deny thy brother. A war's going on, but the reason's undercover. The truth is kept secret, it's swept under the rug. If you never know truth, then you never know love. What's the love, y'all? Come on,
I don't know.
Where's the truth, y'all? Come on,
I don't know.
Where's the love, y'all?
People killing, people dying, children hurting, hidden, crying. Can you practice what you preach? Would you turn the other cheek? Father, 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 help us.
The world on my shoulder. As I'm getting older, your people get colder. Most of us only care about money making. Selfishness got us following the wrong direction. Wrong information always shown by the media. Negative images is the main criteria. Infecting the young minds faster than bacteria. Kids wanna act like what they see in the cinema. Whatever happened to the values of humanity? Whatever happened to the fairness and equality? Instead of spreading love, we're spreading animosity. Lack of understanding leading us away from unity. That's the reason why sometimes I'm feeling under. That's the reason why sometimes I'm feeling down. It's no wonder why sometimes I'm feeling under. Gotta keep my faith alive, love is found. Now ask yourself,
where is the love? Where is the love? Where is the love? One word, one word.
We only got
one word, one word.
That's all we got.
One word, one word.
And something's wrong with it.
Yeah.
Something's wrong with it.
Yeah.
Something's wrong with the good world. We're here. We only got
one word.